Hello, welcome back to Going Walkabout. It's time to start working on the iOS app again. iOS 14 is on the market for quite a while now, and it's time to make some nice iOS 14 improvements. The first improvement I'm working on is picking images. With the introduction of iOS 14, it's now possible to pick images without explicit access to your photo library. The way they do it is by hosting an image picker that is out of process, the user is in control, and the only thing you get back are the picked images. This is a great way to gain trust with your users. As you know, I take privacy very seriously. That's why I don't do any automatic tracking, because you, the user, need to be in control. And now with picking images, you're even further in control. So for me, an important improvement to start working on. Let me first show you what I mean. In the application, there are a few places where we pick images. One is the edit of the profile, as you see here. So we pick an image and we choose one. And actually, what you see here now is a new PH photo picker. It's an iOS 14 specific photo picker that runs out of process, so you don't have control about it. You launch it, you pick images, and what you get back are references to those images. So it doesn't matter. You don't need access to the photo library. You will not get any prompts. You know, application wants to have access to your photo library. It launches, you search, pick images, select them, and with the selected images, you can do anything you want. So let me show you how I implemented that and got it to work. Here we see the function where we pick the image. And the photo, the function here is very simple. If it's iOS 14, we configure the PH picker. We said we want one image, we filter on images because it's for the profile and videos and stuff I ignore. Well, I ignore it anyway in my application, but in this specific case, it's even clear to ignore it. Then we create the picker with the configuration. We set the delegate to the picker and we present the picker. And that's what we do. Now, next we have to delegate. If available iOS 14, we create the delegate. And that has the delegate function. That in that function, the first thing you need to do is to dismiss it, because you have been one launching the out of process picker. You are also the one that needs to dismiss it. It's not going to get dismissed automatically. So we dismiss it. If we have no results, we return. There's nothing to do. In the other case, we get the first result and we get an item provider. And the way it works, it returns a collection of item providers. And with the item provider, you can get access to the underlying media file. That could be an image, it could be one of those live images, but it could also be a movie. I'm only interested in images at this point, and that I took the very easy way. So from the item provider, you check, can I load an image? So the UE image. If that's the case, load it. And remember, this all goes asynchronously. And when you get it back, you get an image and an error. And then on the main queue, we get the self, we get the image. And if we have the image, we set it to the header view, we set it dirty, etc. And that is exactly the same code that I used before here, where we set the image. So that is not specific to the picker, but it's specific to my implementation here. That's what I do here. And that's all there is to it. So instead of, and in my case, I use a custom picker because I wanted to have that grid layout that the default UE image picker didn't provide. So I used the custom one, but for iOS 14, I don't need to do that anymore. And over time, I will slowly phase out that third-party library to do that because I really like what Apple has done here with the picker. Now, there's some more things because from a future project, I also want to get access to the metadata of the image. And there I was struggling a little bit. So I want to point out to you, so that you don't have to go through the same struggle as I have, what I did to get access to the metadata. Now, this is the easy way to do. You don't need any access to your photo library and it works. You get images. But for instance, for a future implementation and improvement I'm working on, I also want to have the date time created of the image, and I want to have the location data of the image. And in that scenario, I need access to the metadata. So this is where I went. Here I have working code, and let me uncomment it so it's a little bit easier to read. Where I get an identifier, because if you pick an image, my results, well, is a list of image providers, and they have an asset identifier. However, if you call the image picker the way I did it, they're always empty. So this only works if you have access to the photo library. And you can do that by setting here, when you configure the picker, the configuration, you create the configuration based on your shared photo library. And if you do that, then automatically it will ask for permission of images. So basically the pre-iOS 14 behavior, you need access to your images, blah, blah, blah. And if you have done that, then you can get the asset, and then you can fetch the assets, and based on the assets, you can get the location. But still, I wasn't happy with this, because this is not how I want it to happen. Because I really want to have the situation where you can pick images without having to ask for permission. Because I really believe that helps gaining trust in your application, and over time, more and more people are going to be more critical about who has access to their photos, etc. So this path, it works, but it's not the way to go for me. So diving a little bit deeper, there's another way to do that. And I'll explain that as well. From the item provider, you can load the file representation. And in this case, for a public item. And that means it will actually load the image into a temporary file that is represented by this URL. And I have the URL. If you have the URL, then I can create the image source, blah, 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 and get actually to the image properties as a dictionary and print that. And that is exactly what I need, because in that dictionary is the original creation date of the photo. And if there is location data available, it's available, because you get access to all the EXIF data in the image to be used. So this is very important for me, because I can pick an image from the photo library. I don't have to ask the user for permission, because the user is in control telling which images to share with my application. I can read those images and I can get the location data out of that. And that's something that I will use in a future version of creating my post. Now, we have seen it working here, but of course I also put it in my trip here where I changed the cover image. And as you can see, it's working quite nice here as well. It's exactly the same implementation. And as a last one, because this is all where I am creating a single image, what you saw here, I set my selection limit to 1, but if I'm creating a story here, I can pick images, and you can see I can select up to 12. I don't have 12, but you can pick more images in order to get them, and you get a result set back that you can use. And this is also the area where, in the future episode, I will tell you I'm working on a new, let's say, create story screen that I will build in Swift UI, but also where you can choose to take the date and location from the image instead of always having now. And that's an idea I'm working on, that you can also, let's say, upload and edit historical trips in your in your diary. Or, for instance, during the day you take pictures, in the evening back in your hotel you want to update what happened today, you upload your photos, and it will take the daytime and the locations of the photos and put them nicely in your trip. So just making it a little bit more convenient for you. That's one of the improvements I'm working on. But now, focus was on the image picker. I think it's great. It looks great. It uses dark mode the way you want if you're on dark mode. And it's a great improvement. And I recommend everyone who is working with picking images, check out this PH picker, because it will really help you, because your application doesn't need access to your photo library anymore. I hope you like it. If you like it, please like and subscribe. If you didn't like it, subscribe anyway, because the next one might be better for you. Well, thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode.